Many of the decisions that we make in life are based on probability. For instance, whether I bring an umbrella to work is going to be based on what's the probability that it's going to rain. If there's an 80% chance of rain, I'm going to take my umbrella. If there's a 20% chance of rain, I'm not going to take my umbrella. So we have a basic understanding of the idea of probability. The probability is simply the likelihood that an event is going to occur. But mathematically, to figure out what a probability would be, we need to have a few more definitions and a little more structure. We have experiments. We don't think about the probability of an experiment happening. An experiment might be rolling a die, or drawing a card from a deck, or going up to bat in a baseball game. We don't talk about those probabilities. What we talk about are the probabilities of a specific outcome of those experiments. Perhaps an outcome of rolling a die might be getting a one, or the outcome of drawing a card from a deck would be getting a jack. That's what we want the probability of. What's the probability when I roll a die that it comes up one? And to find that probability, we look at how many ways a one can come up, how many ways a particular outcome can occur, and we divide that by all the different ways an experiment can occur. So take the dice, for instance. I roll a dice. There are six sides on a standard dice. That's going to be my denominator. Getting a one, that's only one side of the dice has a one on it. So I'm only going to get a one way. So the probability of getting a one is one divided by six. One way that a one can come up when I roll it, six sides on the dice. So probabilities come in two different ways. We have theoretical probability. So theoretically, if I roll a dice six times, one time I'm going to get a one time I'm going to get a two, one time I'm going to get a three, etc. That's theoretical. But in all practicality, when I actually roll that die six times, chances are I'm going to get the same thing twice. That's called empirical probability, what actually happens. So what actually happens when I roll that die six times is going to depend on what comes up. Theoretically, when a player goes to bat, they're going to get a hit half the time. Because when they go up to the plate, they're either going to get a hit or they're not going to get a hit. So there are two outcomes. One of those outcomes is getting a hit. So theoretically, the probability that a player gets a hit is one half. However, if you talk to very many people who play baseball, they don't get a hit half the time they go up. So what you see when you see their batting average is the empirical probability, what actually has happened based on the last 10 times they've been up to bat. They may have gotten a hit twice. So empirically, the probability that they would get a hit is 2/10, because two out of the last times they went to bat, they got a hit. That's empirical probability. That's what happens in real life. Theoretical probability is what happens in theory.
Vizi online texts are a new kind of textbook built with the help of great subject matter experts. These new learning resources have already helped thousands of students succeed. Our original content uses animations, simulations, video and graphics, self-assessments, exercises, and review materials to engage students in their study. Our approach is proven to improve learning outcomes. And that's why Vizi exists, to transform lives by making education more engaging.